7 when I first met the hag. I woke up, wide awake, but unable to move. A tremendous flood of fear washed over me. It was a dreadful and lasting fear, and a sensation like there was someone else in the room, someone not of this world. I wanted to get up and run, but no matter how hard I tried to move or call to mum and dad or cry or scream, I was fixed. Then, slowly, real slow, a figure would emerge from the shadows. I could see it, physically see it edging closer. I could feel it closing in on me. It feels so real. I feel her weight on my chest. I can feel and smell a dank breath in my face like damp stale moss.
Somewhere else to sleep. He doesn't even pay rent. I can't cope with this, mate. It's every night.
What do you care? You're nocturnal.
But I can't hear myself wank.
Good night, Ed. I'll see you tomorrow.
Night, mate.
Mr. Peterson?
Yes.
Oh, I've got a parcel for you.
Oh, great.
Jeez!
She knows you're looking.
What's the matter with you?
She knows of your search. She doesn't like it.
Ignore him. He's drunk. He's like part of the furniture around here.
She wants me to warn you. Don't meddle in what you don't know.
What are you blathering on about now, hobo? Get away from my house.
Look, can I just get you to sign this? I've got to get on with it.
Nice coffee, thank you.
That's my coffee.
Well, it's very nice. Is that the postie?
Yes.
Anything for me?
No. Just this.
Oh, your parcel, your dream reading device.
That's the one.
Not a scam then?
No, I told you it wasn't a scam.
Yeah, I was pretty certain that was a scam. I thought you'd been had, mate. I mean, what, 3 months?
It had come all the way from Japan. It was always going to take a long time.
It could still be a scam. I mean, for all you know, That could be a box full of dirty old pants. Maybe a polished turd.
I think you'd best open it up and check.
Okay.
Is that it?
Well, yeah, I guess so.
Oh, you've been had.
Wait, there's more in here. What's this, some kind of recorder or receiver?
What's this? Instructional DVD?
Give that to me. That's probably the software.
That's probably a virus. There's no way you're plugging that through my laptop.
Good.
So what are you going to do then? Are you going to give it a go?
No, I've got to go to work now. What are you going to do? Find yourself a job?
No. Rocky Anthology.
My Rocky Anthology.
Yes.
Scrounger.
They say that the things we fear can become our obsessions. Never true than in my case. My keen interest in sleep disorders led me to eventually finding employment at the place I used to go as a child for help and be scrutinised and studied like a rat in a maze. The institution of sleep.
Yes, my boy.
Mr. Hollings, sir, it's arrived.
Really? Good, good, bring it in. Oh my good God, that's incredible.
That really is my field of vision. That's unbelievable.
Wow, it's incredible. I knew the Japanese were developing such technologies a good few years back, but now this is a huge leap. They used to have these colossal MRI scanners, and they would pick up activity from the visual cortex and translate it to a monitor. It was really only in its infancy back then, though. Basic tests such as shapes and colours, and the graphics were appalling, but this is amazing. I mean, technology has moved on a lot, especially when you've got the Japanese or the Chinese there at the helm.
It says here that it doesn't just record and transmit the images received or perceived by the brain, but also it translates any activity into code for precise analysis with the software.
Truly remarkable. We are on the dawn of some truly groundbreaking psychological breakthroughs. Ellis, if you can test this and write up a report, I can see this leapfrogging you through the ranks, so to speak. And if you ever manage to capture any footage of this elusive hag, well, I know a good many sources who would pay very appealing money for this kind of research.
Oh, crap. You should listen to me, boy.
Yes, I should listen to a drunk old tramp. That's great advice me off.
She knows what you're doing. She knows you. She won't tolerate it.
Yeah, I'll bet she does. Man, old bastard. Still in your dressing gown.
It's a sports gown. I'm Rocky.
You tit. Let me get tea, I'm starving.
Oh yeah, what are you having for tea?
Those pork chops? What do you fancy some?
No thanks, mate. I'll do you.
You've eaten my pork chops?
Yeah. Well, they look really tasty.
Didn't they just? Do you know, I think there's something serious wrong in my life. Most men of my age come home to a wife and a home good meal. I come home to a raving mad tramp and a housemate who eats me out of house and home. The only woman in my life is an old hag who torments my dreams.
Yep. You're a loser.
Thanks. Chinese it is then.
Ooh! I never say no to Chinese.
And you're sure I can't accidentally fry your brain by flipping the wrong switch or nothing?
No, I shouldn't think so. That's just a receiver.
Shame.
That's it. Look.
Is it? Cool, your eyesight's poor.
No, that's just the quality.
What, and you paid all that money?
It's hardly going to be HD. It's still early days. This is just a prototype. They're still fine-tuning the technology.
It's amazing, really. The future is now. It's like that film with the head things, you know, when Juliette Lewis, she gets her baps out. They sell dreams or something.
Strange Days.
That's the one, yeah. You know, pretty soon you're going to be able to sell all your dreams and life experiences to those less fortunate than you. Not that there's many in that category.
Don't you ever stop.
Hey, if you get a wet dream, I'm getting first dibs.
Right, now that's rigged up, I'm going to turn in. That's recording my subconscious on there, so seriously, no watching it, okay?
Well, you can trust me not to copy any embarrassing dreams and post them up online.
Good, I can rest easy now. Although don't be surprised if you see me dreaming of your demise. I'll see you in the morning. Nothing. Mole activity. Just code, no images.
Waste of time then.
No, it's not. Oh, mate! Will you put some pants on or something? You're hanging out.
Sorry.
No, it's not a waste of time. We can look at this information back at the Institute and see what it's all about. I doubt it's anything we don't already know. Just minor activity, but it's worth diarising.
Waste of time then.
No, I'm not going to bother talking to you. So what are you doing today?
I'm going to watch the Lord of the Rings trilogy.
Not before you've done a shop.
Oh, what can I do online?
Shop's only around the corner, you lazy git.
You mean if I'll get dressed?
Just go. There's a list in the kitchen, and that's just enough to cover it. So no buying cheap crap and pocketing the rest.
As if I'd do that. Again.
Yes, he's here. I'll put him on. It's for you, Ed.
Oh, now what?
What's happened now? This better be important. I'm right in the middle of...
What? Dead? Bloody hell.
I don't know what to say. Yeah. Yeah, I appreciate that. Yeah. I'll see you later.
The news of the tramp must have had some effect on me, as that night's restless sleep led to some strange activity and the first evidence of a dream recorded on the device.
She'll do. She'll have you. Don't turn around. She's unstoppable. She knows you.
Dream captured and it's unidentifiable.
Even so, it's incredible. That's your dream. Can you hear how the sound seems stretched? I'd guess you were probably at stage 4 of the 5 stages of sleep.
Delta sleep?
Yes. Your brainwaves appear to be slower than they would be during REM, when your brain becomes more active and your respiration rate increases. Were you aware that you were dreaming?
I remember waking in the night. That tramp dying. Well, that kind of played on my mind. I knew I'd had a nightmare, but it evaporated almost immediately.
If you'd thought about it, do you think you would have been able to write the dream down at the time he woke?
It's hard to say for sure, but no, I don't think so. It was gone almost instantly.
I wonder if the hallucinations of the hag were to be recorded. Would they be in real time due to the stage of sleep you were in? Well, I think if I could take a copy of this footage, I can manipulate the sounds. See if I can't find the tempo of your brainwaves, so to speak. See if that clears things up and makes it a bit more sense of everything.
That'd be great.
I didn't know what the footage was, but it sent shivers down my spine. It was odd, and yet strangely, for me, it felt wrong to be able to see it.
God, that is freaky, that. Your soul is evil.
Fuck off, mate. My soul is evil? That's a weird thing to say.
All right, mate, it's just a joke.
Well, just don't say things like that.
You are edgy. I haven't heard you swear in years. Hey, you're not having second thoughts, are you? Don't back out of this now. This is just getting interesting.
I don't know.
You pussy. You scared of your subconscious? Maybe you're scared of capturing that hag.
I'm not scared.
Well, what would Hollins think about that?
I'm going to keep doing this. For science. And if you keep on saying things like that and keep making me out to be possessed, then you won't be watching anymore.
I didn't say you were possessed.
Why?
Do you think you are?
Fuck off, will you?
There stood a great chance of eliminating such sleep disorders from these recordings. I just wish that it wasn't my disorder on display, my fears and nightmares. I wanted to stop, but I felt I owed it to the study. To Hollins and the Institute. To the cause. I was nervous. That feeling of impending doom had been with me ever since I saw the footage this morning, like it had awoken something in me. Whatever the footage was, whatever my subconscious was telling me, I couldn't help but feel that it should have been left untapped. I questioned the ethics of such experiments. But at the same time, I questioned my doubts. They were shrouded in a very personal fear after all. I know to Ed, it's all a big joke. That's just how he is. His childish manner prevents him from comprehending the implications of exploring the parts of your mind that we anyone know what this science man revel? Because from where I stand now, I feel that it could send me mad. I closed my eyes and drifted off, burying my thoughts in joyous occasions from my past, trying to keep the shadows at bay.
I'm coming in, bro.
All his life, my friend was haunted by a vision that had eluded him. Well, he finally caught her.
Yet it was her who had the last laugh.
Ed, how are you doing?
I'm doing okay. I haven't been home for a couple of days. I've stayed with friends. I'm going to go back tonight, though. I mean, things have got to move on. Time stands still for no man.
Yes, of course. Well, I wanted to thank you for the device and for the footage.
That's okay. I mean, Ellis would have wanted you to have it. That's why he was doing this, for study. I just hope it was worth it.
Well, it's never worth the ultimate.
No, it's not.
Well, you know where I am if you need me, and you have the number for the office.
Yeah, thanks.
Okay, thanks.
But things happen. Sometimes things we don't like or we don't understand. But life goes on.